Hello everyone, welcome to you all for this session. I am Dr. Asha Thalange and today we are going to discuss another digital modulation technique, FSK, that is frequency shift gain, its modulation and demodulation techniques. At the end of this session, students will be able to represent given bit stream into FSK signal and explain FSK modulation and demodulation techniques. These are the contents that we will be covered in this session. In the previous session, we discussed about digital modulation techniques of amplitude shift keying. We have seen that in amplitude shift keying, that is in binary ASK, the amplitude of the carrier is varied with respect to 1 or 0 of the input bit stream. Frequency shift keying, popularly known as FSK, is another digital modulation technique in which frequency of carrier signal is varied with respect to input bit 1 or 0 of digital data, keeping the frequency and phase constant. Thus, in binary FSK, the signal is represented by two different sinusoidal carriers having different frequencies but same amplitude and phase. Figure shows an example of a bit stream and its FSK signal representation. It can be seen that when the input bit is 1, FSK is represented by high frequency sinusoidal signal. And when input bit is 0, it is represented by a low frequency sinusoidal signal having both amplitude and phase constant. Thus, in mathematical form, FSK signal is represented as VFSK of t is equals to A cos omega C1t when input bit is 1 and A cos omega C2t when input bit is 0. Omega C1 and omega C2 are the two different angular frequencies for two respective carriers. Let us now see how FSK signal is generated. A simple logic to generate a binary FSK signal is to use a 2:1 multiplexer. To the one input of this multiplexer, high frequency sinusoidal signal is applied. Say V1 of t is equals to A cos omega C plus ohm t. And to the another input, a low frequency sinusoidal signal is applied, say V2 of t is equals to A cos omega C minus ohm t. These two signals have same amplitude and phase but differ only in frequency. These two frequencies can be chosen with respect to some reference frequency, say omega C. The input bit stream is applied to the select pin of this multiplexer. Thus, the rate of switching of this switch is same as the bit rate, say RB. The output of this multiplexer is simply BFSK signal as shown in the figure. When the input is logic 1, the switch connects input 1 to output, thus giving a higher frequency carrier signal V1 of t at the output during the bit slot. And when the input bit is 0, switch connects input 2 to the output, thus giving a low frequency carrier V2 of t at the output during its time slot. Thus, the multiplexed output is a BFSK signal. Now, before moving ahead, pause the video and recall ASK modulator used to generate the OOK signal. Welcome back. Figure shows the product modulator used to generate OOK signal. To the one input, bit stream in NRZ format is applied and to the another input, carrier signal is applied and the output is simply the product of these two signals resulting into OOK signal output. This same ASK modulator is used to generate the FSK signal. Let us now see how FSK signal is generated using ASK modulator. Figure shows BFSK modulator using ASK modulators. In this, two ASK modulators are used. Input bit stream in NRZ format is applied directly to ASK modulator 1. whereas the inverted bitstream is applied to the ASK modulator too. To the other inputs of ASK modulators, different frequency sinusoidal carrier signals, say V1 of t a cos omega c plus ohm t and V2 of t a cos omega c minus ohm t are applied as shown. The output of ASK modulator 1 is as shown. It is the product of input bitstream and the carrier V1 of t. Similarly, the output of ASK modulator 2 is a product of inverted bitstream and the carrier V2 of t. These two outputs of ASK modulators are further applied to the summing circuit, whose output is a BFSK signal. When the input bit is 1, output of ASK modulator 1 is a high frequency carrier V1 of t, while its respective inverted value 0 makes the output of ASK modulator 2 0 or no signal during that bit slot. The resultant output of the summing device is an addition of these two outputs and is V1 of t, that is A cos omega c plus ohm t during the bit slot. Similarly, when the input bit is 0, its inverted output is 1, resulting in a no signal at ASK modulator 1 output and a low frequency signal V2 of t at ASK modulator 2 output, which are then applied to the summing device. Thus, during this time slot, the resultant FSK output is a low frequency V2 of t, that is A cos omega c minus ohm t. In this way, BFSK signal is generated using ASK modulators. Let us now see how FSK signal is demodulated. Figure shows block diagram for the coherent FSK demodulation technique. It consists of two synchronous detectors, difference amplifier, low pass filter and a comparator. The incoming FSK signal is applied to both the synchronous detectors. Another input to synchronous detectors are the reference signals cos omega c plus ohm t and cos omega c minus ohm t, having the same frequency and phase as that of the carrier signals used for FSK modulation. The output of both the synchronous detectors are applied to the difference amplifier, whose output is then fed to the low pass filter and comparator. Let us consider the incoming FSK signal during the current bit slot is A cos omega c plus ohm t. The output of synchronous detector 1 is a product of A cos omega c plus ohm t and cos of omega c plus ohm t, which results into a sinusoidal signal expressed as shown. Similarly, the output of synchronous detector 2 is a product of A cos omega c plus ohm t and cos of omega c minus ohm t, which results into a sinusoidal signal expressed as shown. These two products are further applied to the difference amplifier, which results into a signal consisting of a positive DC term A by 2 along with some frequency components. This signal is then applied to a low pass filter, whose output is only DC component A by 2, which is further fed to a comparator having a reference voltage set to 0 volts. As input voltage A by 2 is greater than reference, comparator output is logic 1. Similarly, during the bit slot when FSK signal is A cos omega c minus ohm t, a low pass filter output produces negative DC component minus A by 2, which when applied to a comparator gives the output logic 0. In this way, by using synchronous detectors, FSK signal is demodulated. Let us now see non-coherent FSK demodulation techniques. Figure shows the block diagram of non-coherent FSK demodulator. It consists of a bandpass filter, envelope detector, summing circuit, and threshold device. The two bandpass filters are designed to have a passband frequency same as those frequencies used for FSK modulation. During each bit slot, the incoming FSK signal with some noise is applied to both the bandpass filters. Let us assume that during the current bit slot, the incoming FSK signal is high frequency carrier A cos 2 pi FC plus FDT. This signal is passes through bandpass filter 1 and appears at its output. But the bandpass filter 2 with passband frequency FC minus FD blocks it, thus giving no signal at its output. The envelope detector 1 produces a positive voltage at its output, whereas the output of envelope detector 2 is 0. These outputs of both the envelope detectors are fed to a summing circuit, which gives a resultant positive voltage. This voltage is then compared in a threshold device having 0 volt as a reference value. The demodulated output is thus detected as logic 1. Again, consider a bit slot when incoming FSK signal has frequency FC minus FD. This signal now appears at the output of bandpass filter 2, whereas no signal is present at the output of bandpass filter 1, thus resulting in a positive voltage at the output of envelope detector 2 and 0 volt at the output of envelope detector 1. This gives a negative voltage at the output of summing circuit. At this negative voltage is less than the reference voltage, the threshold device detects it as a logic 0. In this way, during each bit slot, FSK signal is demodulated as bit 1 is or 0. As nowhere in the circuit additional reference synchronizing signal is used, this is a non-coherent type of demodulation technique. So, in this session, we have covered what is FSK signal, its representation, and its modulation and demodulation technique. These are the list of references you can use. Thank you.